Hi, my name's Nigel Howlett, and this is the stage door of the Gordon Craig Theatre. In 1991, I walked through that door for the first time, 28th of September at 8 o'clock in the morning for witness to the prosecution. Stage door is normally used by actors and technical staff to get to the backstage area. So why don't you come and join the backstage area and have a look around with me? So, inner stage door. This is the hub of the Gordon Craig Theatre. We have the stage just here. We have the workshop and the dock area here. And then round here, we have the rehearsal room. Rehearsal room, workshops, everything like that. Why we've got them is because it was a producing house, built in the 1970s as a producing house. A lot of theatres just stop here. That's it, they don't have anything else to do, but we have all this space. Okay, so let's go and have a walk into the scenery dock. Scenery dock is where the sailors, because it was sailors who used to be technicians, would dock the scenery, hence the reason it's called that. We used to store Chitty Chitty Bang Bang. Now, in 1990, Chitty Chitty Bang Bang was produced here for the first time in the country. It wasn't in the West End, it was here. We had two chitty cars. One was the flying car and one was the fixed wheel car. What I'd also like to point out in here, this is the Christie organ. This is where the Christie organ sits. We were the only venue that when we had cinema in, we would do a Christie organ showing at the beginning. They would play the Christie organ and then it would disappear at the beginning of the film. As you can see, at the moment, they're in the process of building the Sleeping Beauty set for this year's pantomime. This is a great use of the venue. We've had, over the years, built a lot of scenery, so it's a great asset to Stevenage and the surrounding area to use that. Obviously, it's gone modern because we're now using MIG welding. We're using a lot of portable tools. But when I arrived in the 1990s, there were still the 1970s equipment, so the fixed bandsaw, the fixed table saw, the planer, the and the pillar drills. All of that has been taken out because it's actually more of a versatile space. Welcome to the Aladdin's Cave of the Gordon Craig Theatre. This is the SM store, the stage management store, where we have nuts, bolts, screws, washers, all the tools, all we need to get us out of the problems that we may encounter when we put a show together. Let's go and have a look at the rehearsal room and some of the dressing rooms. So, this is the rehearsal room. This is the same size as the acting area on the stage. So, what we can do is we can have the actors in here rehearsing and making sure they're getting their lines and their actions right, where the technical team on stage can be putting the lighting and the sound and the setup. It means that we can get productions in and up and working a lot quicker. We also have a set of mirrors. Mirrors are so the choreographer can stand like I am and actually make sure that the dancers are doing what they're supposed to be doing. But he doesn't have to do it in mirror image. It means it can work a lot faster as well. So, I'm now done and I'm a little bit tired. I'm gonna go to a dressing room. So, just got the wardrobe key, master key to the dressing rooms. We'll go up and have a look at those in a minute. But this is the backstage corridor. The stage is there and it means that we can get from one side of the stage to the other. But on the walls, there are some of the posters from the old summer projects that we've done. There's Sister Act, there's Hairspray. All of these shows that we were involved in and they were fantastic. It gives the opportunity for the community to get involved in the theatre. So let's go back down the corridor and we're going to have a look at the green room where the actors rest. So this is the green room. This is where the actors go between shows. Let's go and have a look at why it's called the green room. Well, it's called the green room because it was next to the green. When the first sort of touring shows would go around, there wasn't actually theatres, they were just a green in the village. So they wanted a room next to the green, hence this green. And sometimes as well, it's painted green. The Gordon Craig Theatre one is painted green. On the ceiling, however, there is a lot more memories of all of the shows and very spectacular shows we've had. Well worth a visit if you're able to. A lot of people think the crew sit down a lot when they're doing their job because they have a crew room, which we're sitting in now. Well, no, that's not the case. We actually work quite hard, but it's nice to have an area to be able to sit in and have a cup of tea. So, the Gordon Craig Theatre has 14 dressing rooms in total. On this floor, dressing rooms 1 to 8. These are the stars' dressing rooms. A little bit more plusher than the ones upstairs. Let's go and have a look at one. Dressing room 1. This is where the stars are. Jimmy Carr, Bradley Walsh, Toya Wilcox, Colin Devereux, and lots of others have been in here. Paul Laidlaw actually likes using dressing room 7. That's his favourite one. Our lovely dame from Panto. But this is where we do the makeup. This is where they hang their clothes. This is where they come and rest. So these are the modern equivalent of the old theatrical lights. Each one of these used to be a tungsten light. The issue we had with those was is that they used to get hot and they used to burn people. Now we've gone to LED, so they're very economical and they also don't hurt the people. It's the traditional expectation that everybody has of a dressing room, and it is needed because it means that the actor can see their full face without any shadows and be able to make sure their makeup when they go on stage is correct. So, wardrobe is just here. It's a big room, it's got a lot of stuff inside, but let me go and explain that in there. Come and follow me. So, this is the wardrobe. Again, because the Gordon Craig Theatre was built as a producing house, the wardrobe is 3 times the size of a normal wardrobe. You only get a wardrobe that's this big. So there is the ability to have a cutting table, storage, and the washing facilities. Now, there's a little bit of a story here because in the mid-90s, when they changed all the cladding over, that wall there fell out. As they took the cladding away, we were able to wave at people in Tesco's car park. It also happened downstairs in the couple of dressing rooms downstairs as well. But we obviously got it fixed and they obviously put it back together. But for about 6 weeks, we were open air theatre. Modern flying systems for people are now all done on the bar, and it's all done via counterweights and systems down on the floor. And it's also electronic as well. But when I first started doing it in 93, 94, you actually had to operate this to move the person up and down. And I had the privilege in Aladdin operating the flying system for Barbara Windsor. Barbara Windsor was out there as Aladdin. She would be lifted up, I would lift her up, and she would fly towards me. And I always remember her screaming as the loud of her voice, "Go on, Nigel, a bit higher. It was fantastic. As you can see, this is the sound desk that the Gordon Craig Theatre has installed now. When I first started, sound desks were as long as this desk, because it was all analog. But technology moves forward, as it always does. It's been fun. Now we're going to move into the lighting room. So we're now in the projection room, but there's no projectors. No, unfortunately, in about 2000, we had to take them out because film was going from 35mm to digital, and we felt that we weren't able to progress to digital setup. But when we were here, there were 2 35mm projectors doing crossovers and changeovers. We then went to tower, which was basically the film was built in one big reel and shown as a big VHS cassette. So this side now is only used for lighting control. There are 2 lighting desks here. They've been in the building for the last 10 years or so. They look after all the lighting. Again, upgraded over the period of time the Gordon Craig Theatre has been here. We went from Lee Colour Tram Prestige 2000, which sounds like a pressure cooker, to a Strand 430 to a Strand 530. Strand Lighting unfortunately went into liquidation, and suddenly to realise that all of the lighting equipment was looked after by Strand, as a technical manager at the time, that was a bit of a headache because we had to try and work out how we were going to continually supply the lighting for the stage. But ETC came in and they looked after it, and they have now produced the Ion Lighting Desk. We were able to then upgrade to that, and we were able to purchase 2 lighting desks. It gives us the ability to be a very versatile theatre, having a backup and also a main desk. So this is the nerve centre of the Gordon Craig Theatre, the prompt desk, where the deputy stage manager looks after the show and calls the shows. It's also where the resident stage managers sit and look after the touring shows that come through. It has all the communications you need to be able to talk to people on the fly floor, in the lighting and sound control rooms, and on the stage. Sorry, excuse me, I've just got to do a cue. Yes, guys, could you just change over the... So, we're under the stage now. This is the trap. This is the workings of the trap door. There are five people operating this, four on the weights and one on the slider. The slider is the bit of the stage that disappears, which allows the trap to be operated. So, what happens is, we get somebody to stand on like this, and the four people pull down on there, and I disappear up into the roof. It's a fantastic piece of equipment to have in a theatre. There's not many regional theatres that have the ability to do a trap. Warwick Davis was playing the Genie of the Ring. Now, he kept on saying to us lads, "Go on then, get me higher." He basically wanted us to shoot him out of here as quickly as he could. It was, again, another fantastic moment. We're now sitting in the auditorium. Well, I don't normally sit in the auditorium. I would be sat backstage or up in the lighting and sound control rooms. The auditorium will be looked after by our lovely front of house staff. Those are the people who welcome you and greet you and look after your tickets and organise your ice creams. Over the time of the Gordon Craig Theatre, the auditorium has been refurbished twice. Once from green seats to blue seats, and then from blue seats to these red seats. As you can see, the auditorium rows are continental style. That means you've got a lot of leg room, which is unusual again for an auditorium. So this is the stage. This is where it all happens, the magic. We're on stage left at the moment. You're looking onto the stage. The auditorium is that way, and that is stage right. If you come on stage a little bit further, what we'll do is we'll show you, talk to you about upstage, downstage, stage left and stage right. So, stage left, stage right, upstage behind me, downstage in front of me. But why? Because we always talk about it when you're in the looking out towards the auditorium. That's how we work it out. That's why it's called stage left, stage right. Also called prompt side and OP, opposite prompt. Upstage, downstage, why is it upstage and downstage when the floor is flat? Well, theatres were raked. Theatres were, the actual floor was raked, so it was like looking like that, and you walked up the stage and then you walked down to the stage. You wouldn't see the back corridor wall because, again, that is covered by either a psych or a black cloth. All of this you're seeing now is something that we all hide when you do the show. Lots of memories have happened on here. I've spent a lot of the time on here. My first pantomime, I ended up falling over with a flat. Won an award for it. It is an amazing place. If these walls and these floors could speak, the amount of stuff that they could tell you.